leading diploma in law.
I've had so many opportunities to stay with her as a child growing up. During my formative years, I spent most of my weekends at her place. If you ask me, what are the striking things about her or that we admire about her? Is because she's a person who relates with people based on your level. So basically, she can relate with illiterates, literates, intellectuals. She relates with everybody based on their level. She has no intimidating presence where she makes anybody feel you are beneath her intellectually or she cannot have a conversation with you. Basically, what I'm trying to say is she steps into different shoes depending on the audience she's with. That's the kind of person she is. If you ask me to define her in one word, I'd call her an enigma.
Meeting the Honorable Chief Justice for the first time, she comes off with the impression of a no-nonsense, perhaps unapproachable person. However, this is not the case with His Lordship.
Well, she's a nice person. She accommodates and she is very strict.
When it was almost time for my daughter to start school, that's proper school, at the time we didn't have many good schools in Kano. There was St. Louis Primary School and Capital School. And of course, each time my Lord will ask me, when is Zainab starting school? We discuss things like that. Then, of course, she knew how difficult it was to get into those schools because everybody wanted his child to get into one of those schools. When it was Zainab's turn to get into, I wanted her to get into St. Louis Primary School. And I knew there was a lot you had to do, like you had to queue up very early. You may not be early enough to get your child's name on the list. One day my Lord, the CJN, just called me and she said, this is Zainab's admission. I can't forget that. And that is one of the things that touched me and it still touches me because she was at Zainab's graduation.
Over the years, she has exhibited honesty, integrity, humility, a lot of courage, a lot of patience in dealing with issues around her. And Amasa Aluma has been a source of pride for us, not just women, Nigerians. Anybody that come in touch with Aluma closely, you know that she's a source of pride in dealing with people, in dealing with her job, in executing her job.
Just like the morning shows the day, her childhood revealed her womanhood. Astute, assiduous, courageous, generous. She's quiet. She's kind. The Chief Justice of Nigeria is very firm. She is a role model to many of us. She has listening ear, ready to learn from others.
My first impression is she was a very likable character, very humorous and serious-minded fellow, yes.
I describe her as a very self-assured woman. I describe her as fearless. I describe her as also very, very warm. She has the warmth of a mother, and I hear that she's like that with everybody. But it is so true. She's the warmest person. She's the easiest person to approach. And I know she has a reputation for no nonsense, and she is no nonsense. But with that no nonsense also comes that warmth. So people can be very surprised by the warmth as well.
Her humility is legendary.
She came down to Bogon to see my dad, Sir Joseph Babalake, in the village. That it was important for her to come and let Baba know how much Baba has meant to her all her life and how she has seen Baba as a serious, highly regarded and favorable senior brother, uncle. He calls her Baba Do, But I know that the age between them is about 18 years, but she calls her Baba and kneels down with her two legs to greet the poor old man. Honestly, when I first saw it there on that day, I was taken aback. I mean, she's a 70-year-old woman kneeling down with her two legs for an older man, coming all the way from Abuja to Osun State to come and pay her respects.
How did she cultivate this habit that everybody talks about?
Humility comes positively with everything you do. Once you are humble, then you don't need to fear any fall. As you said, some wonder and say it aloud that the way I present myself and the way I relate with people is such that one can never fathom why a person of my status would behave that way. But it has always been in me. And I believe that when you are humble, you find things easier with people.
When His Lordship took over as Chief Justice of the Federal Republic of Nigeria in 2012, the reputation of the judiciary was at a low ebb, and there was a clamor for a wholesale reform of the judicial system. How far has she gone with the reform?
Well, she has done very well, extremely very well, and I'm sure history will be very kind to her. She's reform-minded. Unfortunately, she's not staying too long to see the reform through. But I also believe that her predecessor, I mean her successors in office, will definitely continue with the good work she's doing until we get to the ultimate destination.
She came down very heavily against indolence by judges in the sense that under her leadership, the NJC stipulated that judges have to write at least 4 judgments per quarter. She also restricted the regular travels by judges.
There is no doubting the fact that since she ascended as the CJN, even while she was a Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, but immediately she ascended that position of the CJN, Justice of the Chief Justice of the Federation, she knew the implications, having risen right from the lower bench, from magistrate to high court, to court of appeal, to Supreme Court. She knew exactly what the complaints or the constraints are, what the problems are. She knows where the issues that has to be coped with, that has to be resolved. And I like the way she went about it. There is no doubt in the fact that people will say, oh, she's really, really hard and harsh, but that is what we need. In Nigeria, there is no two ways about it.
What she's done was required because things have really gone quite bad in terms of the perception of our judicial officers.
If I had my way, I would want the reform to continue. I would want the reform whereby judges are continually put on their toes to discharge their duties. I always say that hard work does not kill. Instead, it helps, because it helps you mentally and it helps you also socially, kind of. Because once you work hard, the respect follows, goes with it. So I would want to see a judiciary whereby the people would approach it with no reservation. People would approach the courts thinking that they would get justice.
Honorable Justice Aloma Mariam Mukhtar, as Chief Justice of Nigeria, she is the first female chairman of the Federal Judicial Service Commission,
When it comes to appointment of staff, that is from level 7 upward for the judiciary, it is the Judicial Service Commission that does this. She will always be there. She's only been there, and she believes she should be there, not because of any other thing, to see that justice is done, fairness is allowed, competence is considered, and quota is followed to the strictest letter. She doesn't believe that because you are a poor man's child, you should not be employed. She sits at the interviews, and at times we take decisions that if we need to vote, we may vote, because you score. I score, everybody scores, and we find every. She has added value to the commission. Not only that, and when it comes to considering appointment of judicial officers, this is one of the roles of the commission. As far as federal judicial officers' appointment is concerned, she's always been dedicated.
She's so transparent. You see, what you see is what you get. She's exactly who she is. She's not pretentious. She's very straightforward, very honest, very just. You know, she tries as much as possible to treat everybody in the same manner, irrespective of your background, social status, anything. She treats everybody the same way. And she's extremely fair in judgment. She's decisive. When she takes a decision, she sticks to it and stands by her convictions. When she believes in you, she stands by you. But that's because she doesn't tolerate indolence, laziness, and she's very upright, straightforward. Like I said, there's several, but they all come to the same thing, her firmness. Like, I believe they're innate. There are things that are inborn that I don't think they're things she acquired through the years. I just believe there were things that she was born with, and it maybe has improved with the years and the kind of profession and her vocation, maybe. But honestly, I believe these are things that have been in her, and they just have been polished and improved with the years.
She is very hardworking, very thorough, result-oriented, and has a wonderful retentive memory. Being a workaholic, if you go to my Lord, the Honorable Justice Aloma's office in the morning, and you find heaps of files and mails on her table, by the time you go back in the evening, the files and the mails are virtually cleared.
Honorable Justice Aloma is definitely somebody who is very vast in her knowledge, very fast in human relation, very good in carrying everybody along in all deliberations, so as to ensure that whatever decisions we arrived at the commission are decisions based on the facts before us, and are decisions that are likely, most importantly, to enhance the judicial system of this country. So she's really a very, very pleasant, very hardworking person, and very, very humorous. Anytime the meeting is getting a bit too cheered up, she brings a joke and everybody will laugh.
One thing again that is very clear about her is her honesty. If she has something, an issue that she needs to clear, she's going to come out openly and tell you, there is this issue that I don't understand, I want it cleared. And she also admits when there are superior arguments, despite the fact that you may have that, I believe, but if there are superior arguments, she will easily give in. She's somebody that I think is very plain, honest, and straightforward to deal with.
If you are not trustworthy, you can't work with her. And you must be hardworking. She based on the truth, nothing but the truth.
I recall the very first day in the office of the Chief Justice of Nigeria. She says, Chief Registrar, come. Sunday, come. Please, you are the Chief Registrar, and I'm the Chief Justice. First, any day I ask you anything that you know I'm not entitled to, you better refuse. If you don't refuse it, and you do it, and I get to know that it's not my entitlement, you'll be in trouble. That was the first law. Secondly, he said, Sunday, I said, make sure you do things right. Anything you have to do must be done right. So the moment you follow all these principles, I won't have any problem with you.
Well, working with her is like working with an open book. She is that kind of person. She's quite open and she's willing to let you learn apart from doing the actual job.
The judiciary is going to miss a lot when she leaves. She has succeeded, unlike any other Chief Justice of Nigeria, to make every judge, whether you are a Supreme Court judge, President of the Court of Appeal, down the line for everybody to be on his toes. And I believe during her time, she made judges to work harder than before and make sure that they deliver judgments on time. And I think you can take that one away from her.
Despite her very busy schedule, Honorable Justice Aloma Mariam Mukhtar did not forget her roots and made immense contributions to the development of Janguza.
You see, all these buildings belong to the father, and she has brought boreholes.
Okay.
Yes, then she sent whatever she has, money for anything we need at home. She sends so many, many things, domestic items, food items, money.
Abunda zan ce akan ta tayi mana